Hello, Acute Angels. This is Teacher Anna, and welcome to another Matinic episode. In this episode, we are going to talk about geometric sequence. Well, at the end of this lesson, you are expected to illustrate a geometric sequence, differentiate a geometric sequence from an arithmetic sequence, and determine the nth term of a geometric sequence. So, what do we mean by geometric sequence? Well, when we say geometric sequence, it is a sequence in which a term is obtained by multiplying the preceding term by a constant number called the common ratio. For instance, the sequence 4, 8, 16, 32, 64 is called geometric because we multiply the same number all over again to the preceding term to get the next term. And the number that we multiplied is 2. And that is what we called the common ratio. It is usually represented by the small letter r. So, how do we determine the common ratio? It is by dividing each number in the sequence from the number preceding it. For example, second term divided to the first term. Or it can be the third term divided to the second term, and so on and so forth. And if we differentiate geometric to arithmetic sequence, geometric sequence increases by the common ratio, while arithmetic sequence increases by the common difference. In geometric, we will be using multiplication or division as an operation, while in arithmetic, we use addition or subtraction. Now, let us see if you can differentiate the two by determining the following examples if it is geometric or arithmetic. Ready? Let's get started. The first one, we have 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. Is it geometric or arithmetic? Very good. The answer is arithmetic sequence because we add 2 to get the next term in the sequence. For the next one, we have 3, 15, 75, 375, and so on and so forth. Is it geometric or arithmetic? Very well. The answer is geometric sequence because we multiply 5 to get the next term. How about the third one? 3, 6, 12, and 24. Is it geometric or arithmetic? That is correct. This one is an example of a geometric sequence because for us to get the next term, we multiply 2 to the preceding term. How about this one? We have 5, 10, 15, 20, and so on and so forth. Is it geometric or arithmetic? Well, you've got it right. This sequence is arithmetic because we add 5 to all the preceding terms to get the next. Alright, since you've already knew the difference of the two sequences, it is time for us to focus on the geometric sequence. Specifically about its general term. Well, the general term of a geometric sequence is represented by a sub n is equal to a sub 1 multiplied to r raised to n minus 1, wherein a sub n is the nth term and a sub 1 is the first term, while r is the common ratio. We use this formula to get a certain term in geometric sequence. For example, find the indicated term using the following information. A sub 1 is equal to 3 and r is equal to 5. and the unknown is the ASAP 7 or the 7th term. For us to get it, we use the formula for the general term of a geometric sequence. We have a sub n is equal to a sub 1 multiplied to r raised to n minus 1. Then we substitute the given to the formula. We now have a sub 7 is equal to 3, the value of a sub 1, and 5 as the value of r. Then the value of n is 7, then we have minus 1. 5 raised to 7 minus 1 is equal to 5 raised to 6. So we now have a sub 7 is equal to 3 multiplied to 5 raised to 6. And then if we evaluate 5 raised to 6, it is equal to 15,625. Then we have 3 multiplied to 15,625. This will give us 46,875. Therefore, the value of a sub 7 is 46,875. Now, let us proceed to our next example. Find the indicated term using the following information. A sub 1 is equal to 8 and r is equal to 3 over 2. And the unknown is a sub 6. For us to get the value of a sub 6, we use the formula a sub n is equal to a sub 1 multiplied to r raised to n minus 1. Then we substitute the given to the formula. We now have a sub 6 is equal to 8 multiplied to 3 over 2 raised to 6 minus 1. And 6 minus 1 is equal to 5. Then we evaluate 3 over 2 raised to 5. We have 3 raised to 5, which is equal to 243. And 2 raised to 5 is equal to 32. Then we multiply 8 to 243, which is equal to 1,944. Therefore, we have a sub 6 is equal to 1,944 over 32. And since it is not yet simplified, we simplified 1,944 over 32. And that will give us 243 over 4. Therefore, the value of the sixth term is equal to 243 over 4. For our third example, find the indicated term using the following information. A sub 1 is equal to 7. A sub 3 is equal to 175, and the unknown is a sub 9. For us to get the value of a sub 9, as you can see, the common ratio is unknown. Therefore, we need to determine first the value of the common ratio before we can get the value of a sub 9. But we will be using the same formula. We have a sub n is equal to a sub 1 multiplied to r raised to n minus 1. Then we substitute the two given in the formula. We have a sub 3 as the value of a sub n is equal to 7 as the value of a sub 1 multiplied to r raised to 3 minus 1. 3 minus 1 is equal to 2. Therefore, we have 175 is equal to 7 r squared. And for us to get the value of r, we divide 7 on both sides. So we have 175 divided by 7 is equal to 7 r squared divided by 7. 175 divided by 7 is equal to 25, and 7 r squared divided by 7 is equal to r squared. And for us to get the value of r, we squared both sides. We now have square root of 25 is equal to square root of r squared. And square root of 25 is equal to positive and negative 5. And square root of r squared is equal to r. Therefore, we have two values of r, or the common ratio, which is positive 5 and negative 5. Let us try identifying the value of a sub 9 if r is equal to positive 5. Substituting the given to the formula, we have a sub 9 is equal to 7 multiplied to 5 raised to 9 minus 1. And 9 minus 1 is equal to 8. And if we evaluate 5 raised to 8, it is equal to 390,625. Then we multiply it to 7. Therefore, the value of a sub 9 is equal to 2,734,375. Again, the value of a sub 9 is equal to 2,734,375. And if the value of r is equal to negative 5, our solution will be a sub 9 is equal to 7 multiplied to negative 5 raised to 9 minus 1. And 9 minus 1 is equal to 8. Then if we evaluate negative 5 raised to 8, it is equal to 390,625. And 390,625 multiplied to 7 is equal to 2,734,375. Therefore, the value of a sub 9 is equal to 2,734,375, which is the same to the first one, wherein r is equal to positive 5. Next, example number 4. Find the indicated term using the following information. A sub 7 is equal to 2,916 and A sub 4 is equal to 108. Find the value of A sub 1 and R, or the common ratio. Well, for us to get it, we only have one formula, and that is A sub n is equal to A sub 1 multiplied to r raised to n minus 1. And if we substitute a sub 7 to the formula, it will give us a sub 7 is equal to a sub 1 multiplied to r raised to 7 minus 1. And a sub 7 is given, which is equal to 2,916 equals a sub 1 multiplied to r raised to 6. And if we substitute a sub 4 to the formula, that will give us a sub 4 is equal to a sub 1 multiplied to r raised to 4 minus 1. A sub 4 is equal to 108, and 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. Therefore, we have 108 equals a sub 1 multiplied to r raised to 3. We now have two equations. 2,916 is equal to a sub 1 multiplied to r raised to 6, and 108 equals a sub 1 multiplied to r raised to 3. Comparing the two, we can easily tell that we can eliminate a sub 1 first by dividing the two equations. Doing that, we will be able to get the value of the common ratio. 2,916 divided to 108 is equal to 27. And a sub 1 divided to a sub 1 is equal to 1, or we simply canceled it out. Then r raised to 6 divided to r raised to 3 is equal to r raised to 3. And for us to get the value of r, we get the cube root of each side. Cube root of 27 is equal to cube root of r raised to 3. And cube root of 27 is equal to positive and negative 3, and cube root of r raised to 3 is equal to r. Therefore, we have two values of the common ratio, which is positive 3 and negative 3. Now that we determine the values of the common ratio, we may now try solving for the value of a sub 1. If r is equal to 3, we have a sub 4 is equal to a sub 1 multiplied to 3 raised to 4 minus 1. And 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. And a sub 4 is equal to 108. And evaluating 3 raised to 3, that will give us 27. And for us to get the value of a sub 1, we divide 27 on both sides. 108 divided to 27 is equal to 4. And a sub 1 multiplied to 27 divided to 27 is equal to a sub 1. Therefore, the first term, if the common ratio is equal to positive 3, is 4. But if the common ratio is equal to negative 3, then we have a sub 4 is equal to a sub 1 multiplied to negative 3 raised to 4 minus 1. And 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. Negative 3 raised to 3 is equal to negative 27. And for us to get the value of a sub 1, we divide negative 27 on both sides. The value of a sub 4 is 108, dividing it to negative 27, that will give us negative 4. And a sub 1 multiplied to negative 27 divided to negative 27, it will give us a sub 1. Therefore, the first term, if the value of the common ratio is equal to negative 3, is negative 4. And we are now down to our last example. In here, we have the given sequence 2, 6, 18, 54, and so on and so forth. And we need to determine what term is 1,458. In short, we need to determine the value of n. So for that, we will be using the same formula, a sub n is equal to a sub 1 multiplied to r raised to n minus 1. Then substituting the given to the formula, we have a sub n is equal to 2, which is the first term, multiplied to r, which is equal to 3. It is by dividing 6 and 2. So we have 3 raised to n minus 1. The value of a sub n is 1,458. And we can eliminate 2 on both sides. So we have 1,458 divided by 2 equals 2 multiplied to 3 raised to n minus 1 divided to 2. 1,458 divided to 2 is equal to 729. And 2 multiplied to 3 raised to n minus 1 divided to 2 is equal to 3 raised to n minus 1. Since n is an exponent, we need to rewrite 729 then into an exponential form, but with the same base 3 for us to eliminate it later. 729 is equal to 3 raised to 6. Therefore, we can eliminate 3 then. So we have 6 is equal to n minus 1. For us to get the value of n, we transpose negative 1. And that will give us 6 plus 1 equals n. And 6 plus 1 is equal to 7. Therefore, 1,458 is the 7th term in the sequence 2, 6, 18, 54, and so on and so forth. And that's all you need to know about geometric sequence. I hope you are now ready to answer your learning activity sheets related to it. Again, the general term for geometric sequence is a sub n is equal to a sub 1 multiplied to r raised to n minus 1. Once again, I am Teacher Anna, and see you on another Matinique episode. Thank you and keep safe.